was your spokesperson of the CPAD. And now I'd like to give the floor to Mr. Liu Yongfu. Ladies and gentlemen, friends from the media, good afternoon. Welcome to the press conference today. And I want to first of all thank you for your long-standing interest and support for poverty alleviation effort.
4月17号 是我们中国的第四个扶贫日。
The 17th of October is the fourth poverty alleviation day of China.
国际消除贫困日。那么就在
And the International Day on Poverty Eradication. Recently, General Secretary Xi once again gave important instructions on the work of poverty alleviation. He endorsed the achievements made since the 18th National Congress in this area, and he spoke highly of the role models and outstanding contributors to poverty alleviation. And he gave requirements and his expectations on the cadres involved in this work. And he called on all party and all society to work even harder to win the battle against poverty. Premier Li also gave instructions. He called on all cadres to work with a greater sense of responsibility, forceful measures, and bolder steps and harder efforts to do real work and ensure that the poor people will be lifted out of poverty as scheduled. Yesterday morning, the leading group Office of the Poverty Alleviation and Development held a meeting in Beijing to hear the touching stories of poverty alleviation. We conveyed the instructions of General Secretary Xi and Premier Li and honored those award winners for poverty alleviation. And yesterday, together with the UN system offices in China and also the Poverty Alleviation Office, we held the High-Level Forum on Poverty Alleviation and Development, which was attended by more than 200 people, including political leaders of 13 countries, representatives of 16 international organizations, and experts and scholars. The Chinese and foreign representatives spoke highly of China's poverty alleviation achievements and the measures of a targeted poverty alleviation. The UN Secretary General believed that targeted poverty alleviation is the best way to help people get out of poverty and attain the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. In several days' time, we will hold the 19th National Congress of the Communist Party of China, and China will go even further in the journey to achieve greater progress and doing greater things and realizing greater dreams. We will be guided by the guidelines of the 19th National Congress of the Party to continue to move ahead in the effort of poverty alleviation. Since the 18th National Congress of the Party, the Party Central Authority with Comrade Xi Jinping as the core has made poverty alleviation a basic line and a signature target for completing the building of a moderately prosperous society in all respects, and it is part of the five-pronged strategy and four comprehensive strategy. And our goal is to lift all rural population out of poverty and lift all poor counties out of poverty and solve the problem of regional poverty. And the entire country is committed to achieve this goal, and General Secretary Xi himself is personally committed, and he has been to all the contiguous poor, poverty-stricken areas, and of his more than 50 inspection tours in China, 30 were about poverty alleviation, and he has been to Fuping of Hebei, Yan'an of Shanxi, Guiyang of Guizhou, Yinchuan of Ningxia, and Taiyuan of Shanxi, where he held five workshops on poverty alleviation, emphasizing time and again the importance of poverty alleviation and giving important instructions. Other members of the Standing Committee of the Political Bureau and the Political Bureau all attach great importance to poverty alleviation and give important guidance. All regions and government agencies earnestly implement the instructions of the central authority, and all social sectors are actively involved in this endeavor. And thanks to the efforts of all sides, we have made good progress in poverty alleviation. First, we have established institutional framework for poverty alleviation, including responsibility, policy, input, mobilization, supervision, and assessment and evaluation systems, altogether six systems providing institutional guarantee for winning the battle against poverty. And we have also advanced work in key areas, including targeted identification, targeted assistance, targeted graduation, targeted fund use, etc. And progress in this area has been made thanks to the concerted efforts of all regions and all sides. The number of poverty population has been reduced significantly, and the outlook of poor regions has been improved significantly. In the past 5 years, in the first 4 years of the past 5 years, the number of poor population was reduced by 55.64 million. That's more than 11 million every year. And this year, at least, we will reduce the number by 10 million. And on average, in the past 5 years, we would reduce the number of poor population by 13 million. As you know, since 1986, we have carried out massive poverty alleviation efforts. That's between 1986 and 2000, annually, the number of poverty population was reduced by 6.39 million, and between 2001 and 2011, the number of poor population was reduced by more than 6 million. So the achievements we made in the past 5 years is the record high. After 1986, we identified poor counties nationwide, Jinggangshan and Lankao, as counties have been lifted out of poverty, and later there will be more poor counties to be lifted out of poverty. And this is for the first time that reduced the total number of poor counties in this country, and it's the first time ever that we've been able to do it. Poverty alleviation effort has not only solved the real problems for poor people and poor regions, but have also improved the capability, governance, and management capabilities of the grassroots level, and improved the working style of local cadres. And we have cultivated large number of excellent cadres and young cadres in rural areas. The transformation of work style will be a valuable asset for our work in the new era. Despite the tremendous achievements we have made in poverty alleviation, there are still problems and challenges. We should never underestimate or shy away from these difficulties and problems. For instance, there is still the arduous task of lifting deep poverty regions out of poverty, and there are still serious problems of disease incurred poverty. And to solve the problems for these regions and these people would be expensive and difficult. And also, there is insufficient effort, perfunctory and bureaucratic approach, or less than satisfactory precision of poverty alleviation. And also, some people or regions are not sufficiently motivated. Going forward, we will continue to follow the strategic thinking of General Secretary Xi in terms of poverty alleviation. We will focus on problem solving and win the battle against poverty. I will stop here. And Ms. Su, and I will be happy to take your questions. Thank you.
Thank you for your briefing. Now, the floor is open. Please state your affiliation before asking your question. I'm from Phoenix TV. You mentioned in your briefing that in some areas, poverty rate is high, especially in Tibet and Tibetan inhabited areas. And what specific measures do you have to address poverty in these regions? Thank you.
现在呢, 我们刚才向大家介绍了,
As I said in my briefing,
扶贫攻坚到2020年入其实现,
there is no problem for us to raise that, realize the goal of eliminating poverty by 2020. Now, the challenge we face is to address the poverty issue in those regions such as Tibet, southern Xinjiang, and other regions that ethnic groups inhabit. Because of historical reasons and other reasons, there is a high poverty rate, and the poverty has been there for a long time. There are over 3 million poor population in 6 provinces. Headcount ratio HCR is over 10% in 5 provinces. If we do not make great efforts in these areas, they cannot reach the goal of poverty alleviation. So the central government has held a meeting on addressing deep poverty and issued documents about it. First, these regions will be the key areas, fund policies will be enhanced in these areas. Second, central government organs will help these regions address this issue with greater support, including the Transportation Ministry, Water Resources Department, Industrial Departments. We'll go all in to help these regions, support them in doing a good job. Third, the provinces will be in charge. Apart from the regions I've talked about, each region has its own areas in deep poverty, and the provinces will identify their own towns and villages in deep poverty, and there must be new supportive policies. Thank you.
Liu 主任你好, 我是中国国际电视台 CGTN 的记者。
I'm from CDC. I visited southwest China for 3 months last year and did a special report. I noticed that their housing, Medicare have been significantly improved and they are more satisfied with their life. And my question is, what long-term measures and mechanisms do you have to prevent these people from returning to poverty? And what mechanisms do you have to guarantee these people have the capability of creating wealth? Thank you. Just as you said, thanks to the targeted poverty alleviation measures, education, medical care, housing, transportation, and drinking water have all been significantly improved in the poor regions. As we continue with our work, we are considering building long-term mechanisms, which covers a lot of areas. While resolving the existing problems, we must think about the future.
基层组织的建设，像这些贫
困村、
这些贫困的乡镇、基层组织的建设要加强。
Of the long-term mechanism,
there must be
leading, there must be a leadership mechanism. Moreover,
we must fully leverage
First party secretaries and stationed poverty alleviation teams. In the long run, we will also train, we will also develop a
trained
people who can lead the development of the local industry. We will also attract the professionals back to their hometown and help build their hometowns after the station teams leave. The fundamental solution lies in development, especially development of industries, education, health,
will
also be included in long-term mechanisms. For example,
healthcare
system, compulsory education, higher education can improve people's educational level. All measures will be taken. Thank you.
感谢主持人，中国日报社记者提问。
China Daily。
我在西藏地区采访自治区采访期间，听到人一个消息，今年七月份呢，有原来是在那曲高海拔地区居住的一些群众呢，搬到了、通过异地搬迁扶贫的一种方式搬进了一个新居。那么这里呢，不仅有新的房子，而且呢是一个温泉的小院。那么这是一种非常新颖的一个异地搬迁扶贫的这么一个模式，因为中国我们幅员辽阔，各地有各种不同的一些类型的贫困的形式导致贫困的原因。那这样这是一种非常新颖的一个脱贫的一个方式。我想问一下，刘永副主任，那么在未来的这个脱贫空间当中，我们还会采取哪些创新的手段来帮助人民群众脱贫致富？谢谢。
To help people get out of poverty. The place you mentioned, actually, I know about it. Is it called Yangbajing? Yes. In Tibet Autonomous Region, the local government has a plan to move people living in high altitude areas, 4,200 meters or even higher, to lower places. Actually, we need more policy support for those areas, like Tibet. The people need to be moved to low altitude areas or valley areas. This could happen concurrently with ecological protection and development. Talking about new measures, I can say that in these deep poverty regions that I mentioned, we will also focus on the poor villages. For villages whose HCR is higher than 20%, we will do more to help them, including infrastructure development, industrial development, local organization building, and changing people's mindset, etc. We will have all kinds of measures to do this. Do you have any?
Now for more on China's poverty alleviation work, we're now joined in the studio by Tang Ning, a counselor with the State Council. Thank you for joining us here on The World Today. One thing China has always taken pride in is the fact that the country has lifted 700 million people out of poverty since reform and opening up in 1978. Help us understand that number. Help us put that number into context. And how impressive an achievement is that?
Okay, I'll put this way. Since 1980 up to now, in the whole world, roughly speaking, about 1 billion